Cutting emissions in transport has become a crucial mission globally, but no solution has been deemed good enough with no downsides. But that was until now. An amazing technology has been revealed which has wowed Tesla enough to make it jump fully on board. What is this game-changing technology that tech billionaire Elon Musk once called stupid? Why has he changed his mind, and who are the innovators that have managed to overtake the almighty Tesla? Stay tuned to find out. It is almost impossible to imagine the lithium-ion battery as a thing of the past, but that is exactly what's about to happen. When lithium-ion batteries first became popular, most people believed the fight with climate change had almost ended, but the real picture is far from the truth. We have now realized that this popular solution bears its own set of unique problems, problems we had never considered before. Most electric cars on the road are powered by lithium-ion batteries. These batteries contain nickel, manganese, and cobalt, forming what is known as the NMC cells. But did you know that the batteries that are championed for being good for the environment are actually not that environmentally friendly? In fact, many stakeholders globally have kicked against the mining of cobalt and nickel and the negative impact that it's been having on the environment in the Congo. What is even more shocking is the serious humanitarian crisis that these batteries have caused in the Congo and Russia. There are many concerns about the unjust labor practices to extract these metals in the Congo. And with several sanctions against Russia due to the Ukraine-Russia war, the auto industry is under pressure to seek alternatives. Desperate researchers have started looking for other options. But there is another problem with lithium-ion batteries. When it comes to performance, these batteries may actually not be as good as they've been advertised to us. These batteries are prone to thermal runaway, which can cause serious hazards like fire. In addition, with a lifespan of 1,000 to 2,000 cycles, they will have degraded by 80% from their initial capacity in a decade. So basically, in a decade or so, the battery capacity will have dropped below the level required by a normal electric car. With all these shortcomings, it's obvious that it's yet again time for a change, and in a fast-paced world like today's, a revolution is always around the corner. This is where hydrogen comes in. If you studied science in high school, you'll be familiar with hydrogen on the periodic table. Hydrogen has always found itself to be the talk of the town amongst chemists. This time, however, this anomalous element is finding many admirers in the auto community too. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe. This is important because of its immense potential as a clean energy source. Hydrogen can be produced from renewable energy sources such as solar, wind, or hydropower. Imagine the future of automobiles powered by an endless resource. So, how does a hydrogen fuel cell work? Well, it produces electricity by combining hydrogen and oxygen, with water vapor being the only byproduct. Because of this efficient reaction, cars can refuel in about 5 minutes, or even as fast as a fossil fuel-run vehicle. One of the biggest advantages is that you will not have to wait for hours to charge your electric vehicle. And not only that, cars running on hydrogen can go up to 400 miles per refuel, compared to about 200 miles in many battery electric cars that are not expensive. And what is more is that their performance is not impacted by extreme weather, such as sub-zero temperatures and desert-like conditions like that of battery electric cars, so you are a lot less likely to experience any Tesla-like situations. Moving on to the energy density, while the lithium-ion battery has an energy density between 200 and 300, the energy density of hydrogen fuel batteries is, wait for it, a whopping 35,000. This means that these cells can store a lot more energy in a small volume. Now, you may be wondering why, with all these advantages over lithium-ion batteries, why we are not spotting any hydrogen fuel cell vehicles on the road, and you are right to have those questions. Well, there are multiple reasons for that, and most of them are because this is a novel technology. Back when normal EVs were launched, they also faced the same issues. Firstly, the cost of such vehicles is currently higher than that of other kinds. However, the good news here is that the prices are expected to lower in the future as the demand increases, just as the prices of EVs lowered over the years. Secondly, with not many hydrogen-run vehicles running around, the number of refueling stations is much less. But as with the battery electric cars in the beginning, this is also expected to improve, and we are sure to spot many refueling stations around. Also, as a highly inflammable gas, hydrogen is difficult to store and transport. This has always been a matter of concern amongst chemists and engineers. In fact, sometimes this concern has been blown out of proportion. However, these engineers working on this technology are keeping safety as their top priority. Nevertheless, with all these drawbacks and some more, over the years the critics have deemed the switch to hydrogen-powered vehicles impossible. But you know, with the auto industry, impossible really just means not yet. And in the fast-paced world of today, the transition from impossible to possible happens pretty quickly. It only takes one idea, one team, and one company to power the possible. And in this case, the company happens to be ZeroArvia. ZeroArvia is a company working on the next generation of power plants and engine replacements for not just cars, but heavy aviation vehicles such as commercial planes. But how is the EV industry reacting to the emergence of hydrogen fuel cells? Of course, it is impossible to talk about electric vehicles without mentioning Tesla. Expecting Tesla not to dive headfirst into new EV technology is like trying to hold back the tide. This time, Tesla's venture into the hydrogen fuel cells may be a little shocking. This is because Elon Musk, Tesla's CEO, has been very vocal against these cells in the past. In fact, he has repeatedly called these cells fool cells, idea of hydrogen fuel cell vehicles as mind-bogglingly stupid and the dumbest thing for energy storage. Trust Musk to always speak his mind without holding anything back. Now, when asked why he was so against the idea, he said that it was because these cells were very inefficient, expensive, and too complex to store and distribute. Basically, all the reasons we've already pointed out. But now, is Tesla finally announcing the development of a hydrogen-powered vehicle? Or perhaps he realized that a change in strategy was required in response to the demands of the market and competition. One thing that we know is that Tesla never shies away from competition, even when other big names in the auto industry have already started running in the race. This reported change in stance may also be an attempt to diversify Tesla's energy solutions and provide new technologies to the customers to maintain a competitive edge, especially since the company always faces relentless competition from companies like China's BYD. According to speculations, a Tesla hydrogen-powered car will fit into the company's existing lineup by naming it the Model H. And the model could show impressive acceleration of 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 1.2 seconds, reaching up to 280 miles. But Tesla doesn't need to embark on this journey alone. In fact, it's collaborated with the largest EV battery maker in the world, Contemporary Amperex Technology Co. Ltd., or CATL, from China. Unfortunately, this relationship has always been a subject of criticism amongst congressmen in the US, as the relations of the United States have worsened with China. The relationship between Tesla and CATL is not new. In fact, Tesla already uses lithium iron phosphate batteries, or LFP cells, from CATL in their Model 3 and Model Y in different markets. Tesla is also collaborating with CATL on fast charging batteries. Not only that, though, Tesla is also set to build a new battery plant using CATL cell designs. This is proof enough of Tesla's long-standing relationship with CATL, and it looks like the relationship is set to become stronger. This time, the duo can decide to take their relationship to the next level and enter the hydrogen fuel cell revolution together. The two can work closely on advancing hydrogen fuel cell technology. The power duo can promote the adoption of hydrogen-powered vehicles by enhancing battery chemistries and optimizing charging times. It is a no-brainer that Tesla and CATL will come up with innovative technology that will propel this industry much further into the future. And with Tesla's influence, more people are bound to be attracted to this novel technology. But until then, let us focus on the company that's already been making waves in this field. If you've been closely following news of green investment, you might have come across the name ZeroArvia. In fact, the company has been named America's top green tech company for 2024. So what made the company achieve this amazing feat? Well, it was the breakthrough development of their turbocharging high-temperature hydrogen fuel cells. ZeroArvia has been working on the bigger issue that looms over the emissions problem, commercial aviation. They want to create solutions for large aircrafts that go longer distances and cause the majority of emissions. This company strongly believes that hydrogen is the only answer to the emissions problem. According to Valery Miftikov, the founder and CEO of ZeroAvia, what's important is high energy density and high specific energy, amount of energy that you can put on the aircraft, and the amount of power that you can generate per unit of mass and volume, and that's where we believe that hydrogen is the only answer. But what makes them so confident in this technology, and why are their fuel cells so much more power dense? In January 2023, ZeroAvia achieved the amazing feat of flying the world's largest hydrogen electric aircraft with a standard low-temperature fuel cell in the powertrain. The company has been pressing forward since then. Regional airlines have already started queuing for their hydrogen electric engines, but ZeroAvia's sights are at bigger feats. They want to power bigger planes that release only water vapor and heat. ZeroAvia, like other big companies, started off by identifying a problem. They realized that they could build on the problems faced by the conventional low-temperature fuel cells and make them suitable for aviation. But before heading into their technology, let us first understand how PEM fuel cells work. Conventional fuel cells make use of a membrane called a proton exchange membrane, or the PEM. These fuel cells have been around for a while, as they were developed almost around 60 years ago by General Electric. They were even used by NASA in its Gemini space program. But what is the function of this proton exchange membrane? Well, this membrane actually causes the chemical reaction that produces electricity in these fuel cells. This is how all this ties up. There are three important parts in the fuel cell, which are arranged in layers. On either side, you find the bipolar plates that organize the flow of molecules. Inside these layers, you find gas diffusion layers made up of carbon on either side. These layers are responsible for making sure that the molecules flow evenly into the main compartment. This layer, along with catalyst and membrane, is called the membrane electrode assembly, or the MEA. Now that we're clear about the setup, let us see how the thing actually works. First, hydrogen and oxygen gas enter separately through each bipolar plate. Hydrogen is broken down into protons and electrons through a catalyst layer made up of platinum. The membrane lets protons pass through to the cathode but redirects the electrons. The electrons are pushed through a circuit which produces the electric current. The electrons then rejoin the protons and then oxygen to produce water. The only other byproduct of this reaction is heat. As we already mentioned, most fuel cells run at low temperatures, between 65 and 90 degrees Celsius. This seems feasible and reliable, however, there is one major problem with this setting. It takes a lot of effort to maintain cool temperatures. Heavy water cooling systems called the balance of Planck components are needed, and this is why this system is not suitable for planes. Well, that was only until ZeroAvia came into the picture with its new technology. After recognizing the problem, the folks at ZeroAvia came together and started building a solution. And their solution actually seems pretty simple. Since their fuel cells operate at higher temperatures, they need additional cooling. What they did was that instead of using water cooling systems, they used direct air cooling. This not only saves them a lot of space, but also means they do not need to use any heat exchangers or coolant pumps. However, typically air cooling is not as effective as water cooling. But since this is a high-temperature system and it's easier to bring down a hot object's temperature than a cool one's, this system works out pretty well. But that's not all. ZeroAvia even uses the extra heat and pressure by using it for turbocharging, just like in a car. Their air cooling technology, along with the turbocharging feature, provides additional benefits. It reduces tank weight and maximizes the power output of their fuel cells. This is because the turbo uses energy from the exhaust to spin a turbine, which in turn spins a compressor. The output of this compressor is oxygen-dense air that's fed into the fuel cell. Now, ZeroAvia has managed to make this solution sound very simple, but you may be wondering, if the solution is so simple, why isn't everyone else doing this too? Well, it turns out things are not all that simple when it comes to high temperatures. To reduce the weight of the fuel cell, ZeroAvia decided to use the lightweight metal aluminium. However, at very high temperatures and with phosphoric acid as the electrolyte, aluminium tends to dissolve. This is definitely a big problem for the cell. To fix the problem, the company used what they call the bipolar aluminium plate. This plate is not only corrosion resistant, but also has greater conductivity. The plate is coated with their proprietary polymer composite, which, for the first time ever, has enabled aluminium to survive very high and corrosive conditions. So the company's success can be largely attributed to its innovative solutions to complex problems. With its lightweight body and groundbreaking thermal management system, hydrogen fuel cells can find applications in many areas. This is a huge point in favor of hydrogen because the world actually runs on machines that need large amounts of energy, such as heavy-duty trucks, ships, and trains, and who knows what else in the future. A battery like Zero Avia's that can power a commercial airplane can definitely take care of these problems for us too. Now, with all the pros of the hydrogen fuel cells listed, you must be wondering about the challenges of this cell. Well, there are a few. First comes upholding the green part of this green tech company. To produce hydrogen, Zero Avia uses green sources, and the more popular that this technology becomes, the company needs to brace for an increased demand for its green hydrogen, which will take a lot more effort and resource to create. Besides that, the company also needs to be prepared for an increased output to keep up with the growing number of customers. However, that is something that one can expect the company to be able to handle. In fact, the company plans to hit the market within these 2 years, and it seems like things are already working in their favor. As prices of commercial flights are increasing and greener alternatives are given more subsidies, companies like Zero Avia are set to achieve massive growth. It looks like the company will dominate the market in no time. The tides are changing. A hydrogen-powered future, once a myth, has started to roll into action, with companies like Zero Avia, Tesla, and CATL pioneering this revolution. Hydrogen fuel cell cars are predicted to take over in the next decade.